Something is brewing, about to begin. Calmly finger on what lies in store. I feel what's to happen, or happened before. A father, a mother, a daughter, a son. Chim chim, chim chim, cherry chim cheru.
Hurry up, James, let's run! Take the key of this one! You can't pretend you're even against it! I'll teach you my lesson if I'm blind and kind and you can't make it! Get up, you ass man!
Ah! Boy, that hits you again! Come on now! Boy, come here!
Stop! that states the children in Michael Bay's require the best nanny possible at the lowest possible wage.
We better get them on before they make another mistake.
I would stress the part about the wage.
What's that you're holding, dear?
Leave us now,
our own investment. What on earth?
Please, George, I think we should hear it.
We're afraid none of your theatrics.
It won't hurt to listen.
Now,
club, and as you can see, a screamer's an artist of highest degree. And it's all the outwork from the own memory.
And lovely work it is too, Bert. Admiral, do be a darling and give him a tear.
Quite often enough.
on a nice sunny day like this.
Lost your marbles.
It's your fault, isn't it? I know.
Someone else's wife.
when I'm small. Just learn a trade.
Today I see.
Can't keep the street ship shape, Admiral.
Tell me, Bert, how are things aboard number 17 with Mary Poppins? All ship shape, I trust.
There's rough weather on every voyage, Admiral.
Miss Locke, what those two children need is a touch of the cap and a night on the yard.
Very nasty medicine.
My collateral is more than adequate, and Latin America is an expanding market. What is the matter? Have you no courage?
But Mr. Von Hustler, what I haven't been able to grasp is, what exactly is your final product?
What is the product? To make money! Of course.
Yes, money. But I wonder, money making money, is it enough?
Are you man enough to be a banker? I man has dreams to build an empire, to make his name in many foreign lands. Put in the new world, I am told.
You won't regret it. The factory could be running in weeks and expanding before the year's out. Please, Mr. Banks, I'd give you everything I've got. Believe me.
I do believe you, Mr. Northbrook, and I've tried, but there's simply not the collateral.
What about my workforce? Decent men who want a better living? They're my collateral. My men have dreams to earn an honest living. A wife and kids. A home to call their own. If you invest in us today, it pays away. I promise we'd repay the loan.
I'm sorry, Mr. What are you doing here? Can't you see I'm busy?
No, we're done. And no man should be too busy for his own children. What brings you in here for, young man? Have you come for some money as well?
Hardly. What would they need money for?
Well, it's never too early to learn its value.
I know the value of this. 6 pence.
No, that's its worth. Its value is how you spend it. Do good, and may you have good luck.
And what do you say to Mr. Northbrook?
Thank you!
I'll wait outside.
Now, what on earth, really, Mary Poppins? I am not without a sense of humor. I am not, and when I was a little boy, I never dared interrupt my father.
Were you ever a little boy?
Yes, and my nanny, Miss Andrew, kept me out of my father's way, and he'd been very annoyed if she hadn't.
What about your mother?
I don't think I saw either of them more than once a week.
Didn't they mind?
Mind? They were glad to be rid of me.
Who kissed you goodnight, Miss Andrew?
No, of course not. There was no time for hugging and kissing and all that soppy nonsense. What's the matter?
Poor Daddy.
Poor? What do you mean poor? That made me the man I am today, eh, Mary Poppins?
Yes, I'm afraid it did.
That's enough. Now you've seen where I work and I have a great deal to do, so get it.
Daddy, when you invest the bank's money, what are you looking for? A good man?
I suppose I should say a good idea. But a good man is much rarer and much more valuable.
Come along, children.
Mr. Von Hustler, I've considered your arguments, and the answer is no.
So, you don't recognize a good idea when you see one?
Maybe not, but I do recognize a good man when I see one.
You will regret this, Herr Banks!
Your factory of
Now you can tell her yourself.
Bring him down his box, dog, will you?
Don't interrupt when someone's barking. You were saying...
Mary Poppins!
to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leave through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation keen. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious. If you say it loud enough, you're always so precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
See you.
bring in. Good news or bad, happy or sad, the pendulum keeps swinging.
Ask yourself, who looks after the fathers when things go wrong?
for blown and curved. Between pavement and stars as a chimney sweeps worse. Where there's hardly no day, hardly no night. There's things off in shadows, halfways in light. On the rooftops of
precision and order, it's perfectly true. Can really make a difference, I found her for you. Clear thinking, sound judgment, and the will be there. A home you can be proud of in Cherry Tree Lane. Hurry up everybody into the pool, I want to define everything. Six.
It's not much of a haul. so happens today I'm a chimney sweep. Now, what's the matter and who's that for you?
The nastiest nanny in the world.
Oh, the nastiest nanny in the world, eh? Well, you kids should know you've been through enough of them. Is she really as bad as all that?
She looks like something that would eat its young. This Andrew is Daddy's nanny, which explains a lot. Mary Poppins used to say he needed our help, but now it's too late.
No, I wouldn't say that. I'll tell you what, why don't we start things off with a bit of a shake for good luck?
Why are we shaking hands with you to bring us luck?
Well, didn't anyone ever tell you it's lucky to shake a sweep's hand?
But what do? If you want some luck?
Well, I shake hands with myself. Now, what have we here?
You always wanted to fly a proper kite.
I always wanted to fly one with Daddy.
Of course you have. But you got to know how it's done first. Get some training in it. You'll make him the proudest father in the whole country.
You really think so? You're not just saying that.
Did I say the country? The whole blooming empire will like. With tuppence for paper and string, you can have your own set of wings. With your feet on the ground, you're a bird in flight. With your fist holding tight to the string of your kite.
sore eyes.
You really are. Welcome back, Mary Poppins.
See, I told you they were good kids.
And I told you they were worth bothering with. Come on.
Now see here. It's against the regulations.
Coming down from the sky like that.
And where from? I want it now, eh? Where from?
If I were a car keeper, I should straighten my cap and button my coat. Come along, children.
Aren't you going to shake hands for fur, for some love?
No.
Why not? We have.
I don't need any luck, thank you.
Thank you.
are seeing a lark in a cage for the first and the last time.
Wandering in the park.
George!
Good night, man.
Yes, if I had one.
George, you haven't noticed. Mary Poppins is back.
Oh, Mary Poppins. Well, well. Might I have a word? I won't beat around the bush. Things have not gone well for us since last July.
About my wages, sir. If you don't mind, I won't take any just now. I should prefer to let them accrue.
But Mary Poppins, if you only had any idea how many payments are accruing as it is.
Is everything all settled then? It is. Now, I must get started. Jane, Michael, this one.
Frosty curbside.
We will still have what really matters, the children and each other.
Thank you.
look at them from a little higher up. And always remember, there's plenty of folks ready to help you. Covered in soot, and they're up on your roof.
Chim, chim, honey, chim, chim, cherry.
See? It's true.
Rust away the dirt and soot. Rust away your tears.
Stepping tall.
chairman wants to see me by close of business tonight.
Tonight? Well, I'm going with you, and very well give that chairman a piece of my mind.
That would only make matters worse. It seems tomorrow I shall be joining the ranks of the unemployed.
Oh, George, are you quite sure?
Quite sure. Yeah. We'd better make some plans. In fact, I think it may be time.
You don't mean your mother's bars? Oh, won't you miss it terribly?
Needs must, my dear. We always said we'd save it for a rainy day, and tomorrow it looks set to fall. Good luck to you too. I suppose Mary Poppins put you up to this?
No, she hasn't said a word about it. But we know it's been difficult for you lately. We haven't really been much help. So we thought a bit of extra cash might loosen things up a little bit. It is a whole shilling.
Thank you.
Good night, Daddy. We do love you.
Jane, do you remember you once asked me who Nelius's father was?
Yes.
It is Poseidon, king of the sea.
Anything can happen.
hollow. It had no product and no substance. It had no meaning outside the walls of a bank. Yes, he spoke of product and substance and asset, but nothing of the people. I know if a man puts any value on the outside world, then you think him a washout. But I'm afraid I do value it, gentlemen. In short, George Baines, Esquire, has rediscovered the human race. I apologize for ruining your bank, but I do not apologize for learning that there are more important things in life than money.
Ruining the bank. Ruining the bank. Ruining the bank. My cat, have you not heard? You say that bacon. My hustler scheme has ruined our rival. Yes, yes, yes. Hey, you kept us out of the worst of scandals since scandals began. And we're not here to accept your apology. We're here to offer you ours.
Oh, my God.
Yes, and do you remember a cat by the name of Northbrook?
Uh-huh.
He's repaying his loan, and he's opened two new factories. And the percentages that you negotiated is trying to make us a fortune!
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Speaking of that, you were. Could you tell us how you did it? I mean, like, give us the word. It'll be safe with us.
Give you the word?
Yes, give us the word.
Give you the word?
Yes, give us the word.
Oh, I'll give you the word. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious! Even though the sound of it comes from the right of the room,
exactly how much?
Of course.
And Mary Poppins, that was the best yet. To be a fan of heaven. Do you think we'll ever go back?
Yes, someday.
Really? Will it be soon?
Oh no, not for a very long time. But you can keep an eye on the stars until then. Here.
It's a telescope.
So it is. Keep it if you like. It's a present.
Thank
you. Now, run along in. It's getting cold.
I think you'd better come and dance with me.